games to get the kids moving for children between 3 and 6 years. Getting colder, getting warmer. Recommended age from 3 years old. What you need: 2 players, an object you can hide, a room. Rules: one of the 2 players hides the object in the room, for example, a ball made of paper or of kitchen foil, while the other player has his eyes closed. Now, the other player opens his eyes and starts looking for the hidden object. He looks for the object by moving in the room, while the other player who hid the item gives him hints like this: cold if the player is far away from the object, warm if he's getting nearer, hot if he's very, very, very close. Tips: if you want to increase the difficulty, give yourself a maximum time to find the object. Warning: especially if you play with young children, pay attention that they do not climb furniture or get into danger to hide the object. Establish the rules from the start and never let them play all by themselves. Clouds Rush. Recommended age from 3 years old. What you need: pieces of cotton wool, paper masking tape, and straws, but this is optional. Rules of the game: build a racetrack with 2 parallel pieces of paper masking tape. The track can be straight or have curves, this is up to you. Each player positions himself at the start of the track, and one at a time, taking turns, every player blows his piece of cotton, his cloud, along the track. You can blow the cotton wool with the help of a straw or simply by blowing really hard with your mouth, like what the wolf does in the Three Little Pigs fairy tale. The player blows and blows until the cotton cloud reaches the end of the track, but pay attention not to let the cloud go off track when you blow. Circle the chair. Recommended age from 3-4 years old. What you need: a chair. It would be best if it was a plastic chair. In some circles, you can make them by creating a salami shape with kitchen foil or newspapers that you will then close with adhesive tape in the form of a circle. How to play? Turn the chair upside down as shown in the picture below so that the chair stands still with its legs facing the players. The players stand in front of the chair, not too close, and try to throw the circles so as to center one of the legs. Earth and water. Recommended age from 3 to 6 years old. What you need: paper masking tape, or a piece of rope or of chalk to write on the ground, but only if parents and educators gave you permission to do so. Rules of the game: draw a line with the paper masking tape or the chalk on the floor or ground, and this line will divide the earth from the water. Determine at the start which part of the floor will be the earth and which one the water. A player, or a parent, or an educator will be the one who says earth or water. The other players must jump in the correct half of the floor according to the instructions or stay still if the command is the same. Pay attention to this: you cannot turn yourself around to jump, so one time you jump forward, the second time you jump backwards. Those who hesitate to jump or make a mistake quit the game. Whoever remains in the race until the end without making mistakes, and therefore without being eliminated, wins the game. Tips: if you play this game inside your home, you might want to substitute jumping with walking. Just take a step forward or a step back, depending on the command. Guess Who? Recommended age from 4-5 years old. What you need: a small ball or a little pasta piece, something you can easily hide in your closed hand without the others seeing it. A floor large enough so that all the players can sit in a circle together. Rules of the game: everybody sits in a big circle together. Everyone passes the ball with his right hand behind the back to the person on his right. It's up to the single player to decide whether he passes the ball on or if he keeps it in his hand. However, this change shall continue even if nothing is passed on, really. When your hand is touched by the person on your left, either to give you the ball or empty, you close your right hand and leave it closed until the end, except if you want to pass the ball, but then you close your hand again quickly. The person who started the game will have to guess at the end of the first round, that is, when the person on his left closes his right hand, where the ball stopped. It asks, who has the ball hidden in his right hand behind his back? If this person guesses it right, the two players swap places and the game starts over. If he cannot guess who is hiding the ball, he starts the game again until he can guess it right. Obviously, the player who has to guess cannot see what is happening behind the other player's backs. The aim of the game is not to win, but just to have fun guessing. Have fun!